Come on, guys, I'll go up and walk you.
So how many have we got in here in total?
One, two, three,
six.
Seven.
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 Count
the legs
and you've got
that. Six.
Six. Let's just make sure
we've
got this right.
Look at you,
lucky girl.
Seven,
the white one.
Do you reckon one day we'll have our own
birds?
We want to over encourage, because otherwise the minute a visitor walks in the field they're mobbed by sheep, and some people find it a bit oppressive, you know. And also you don't really want children touching them, but if you actively show that you're trying to get people to touch them, then you have to go down the health and safety route and saying this is a touching experience, and it's not. The idea is not to have the sheep up around people's ankles. You want them so they recognise this bucket one and only, and they do. And if you can keep it the similar sort of time of day, that's fine. We always, that sounds silly, but we always say sheep, right? And they do know.
Screams of the weather.
So it's literally no more than that, really. It's so that you just come up and have a little taste. It's a double handful. And that should last for the entire time. Just something to rattle. And we're not supposed to be supplementary feeding, that's why it's such a small amount. The whole idea of the conservation is to produce a facility. Add to it. Say this to everybody, once you get used to stock checking, you find yourself walking to any field, wherever it is, and you think water, poo, you know, and you do it automatically. It's just for the first few times you do it, you can just sort of get it into your brain what needs to be done. The most important thing is that every day I know that it's being covered. Obviously at the end of every day, if it's not being done, I'll have to just double check who's doing it. And the other thing is fly strike. We've treated them for flies. They've all been shorn, you should be able to see it. If there's lots of flies sitting around on the backs, it might be under the trees, something like that. Or you see them acting strangely, you know, they're broken away from the rest of the flock, they're doing something that doesn't quite look normal. Try and have a closer look. If you're concerned, phone me up. And so let me talk it through.